got brutal on the scene, wicked and mean. You know the jump shot clean, keep it a beam. And in the lane, baby, flow the soft with a lean. And when you put me on the block, call me the dream. And I really played the game, I know the rules. Don't bring me half-ass shit, I know the moves. Plus I know you like the video, so hit that like. Really play.
What up? What up? It's ya boy. You don't know brutal sim on the scene, wicked and mean, with a next video for y'all, man. So y'all know how it is, y'all. Brew squad, stand up. We out here, man. We in the building. We in the building. Anyone y'all got that notification bell on lock? Trust me, man. Put that notification bell on lock and put Brew Squad in the comment section, man. I do appreciate y'all, man. Y'all know how it is. The grind don't stop. And I got a nice requested video. A lot of people been asking me to get back to my tutorial, get back to my tips and tricks. And I'm gonna really start pushing at it, man. Gonna start pumping out these tip and tricks videos, man. As y'all see the title, man, this title is gonna show y'all the 9 things y'all need to work on to get a big boost on your jump shot percentage. It's that simple. It's that simple. Now I got all the tips here, and this is something I kind of, you know, figured out over the long period of time of me playing the game, man. All right, so let's get straight to the video. Right now, the first thing y'all need to do is find a jump shot that fits you. Now, specifically, y'all know how it is in the community, y'all. Everyone is copy and paste. Of course, some of the most popular jump shots out there is 38, 49, 98, and I think Trey Burke, amongst others. But we already know there's a certain set of jump shot that a lot of people are using based on popularity. But I've been playing against so much people with weird jump shots, and they're just straight cashing. And I'm wondering, what the hell is this, right? So I'm seeing there's a bunch of jump shots out there that a lot of people are not using, and you just might have to find your own, because not every jump shot fits every person. We think because it's a good jump shot, it's gonna go in, not necessarily. All right, so I suggest you find your own jump shot that you really get some success with, and then we're gonna work on it from there. All right, now let's move on to the next point real quick. And this is something that a lot of people don't mention, is it's very important to go to your mic court and practice. And not only practice, but look for jump shot cues and not work on jump shot timing. Now stay with me 1 minute, man. Y'all know how the game is. Pretty much every other court you go to, there's a different timing to your jump shot, so it throws your jump shot off a little bit. But if we start looking for jump shot cues, which is what I start doing, me personally, whenever I release my jump shot, I wait until my hand reach my face and then I release the jump shot. That's the cue I always look for with my jump shot that I'm using, and it works no matter what court it's on, man. All right, now you are gonna see a difference in whenever the hand reach your face based on the game speed or however the server is working on that day. That's why it's so much more important for you to look at jump shot cues and not jump shot timing. Now it's important to highlight there are multiple cues you will have to look for, not just catch and shoot. There is the catch and shoot cue you have to look for, there is the pump fake cue, there is the cue for you to figure out for the off the dribble shots, and there's a cue for the moving shots, amongst others in the game. So pretty much for every different occasion, the jump shot timing is a little bit different, which means the jump shot cue will be different as well. Now let's move on to my next tip, which is number 3 on my list, which is after you figure out the cues and then practice your cues enough that you're really comfortable with your jump shot, then I suggest that you remove that shot bar. Y'all already seen most of the competitive people do not play with their shot bar for the simple fact that you do receive a 5-6% boost. And I'm telling y'all, with my build, I saw a huge difference with me removing that shot bar. So I suggest that you remove the shot bar. Now this isn't guaranteed if you're not sure about your cues as yet, but after you go through my steps and you practice and then you start seeing these cues, it becomes easy for you after a while. Please remove the shot bar. It will do wonders for your jump shot. Trust me. Now, number four on my list. Now, this is for people that receive the ball and shoot, man. Please do not hold the shot button before receiving the ball, man. If y'all don't know, 2K actually penalizes you. I think Mike Wayne mentioned this a while ago before the game dropped. He was giving certain tips about jump shots, and he highlighted that the game really penalizes you for holding the jump shot button before releasing the ball. So wait until you receive the ball, then press the jump shot button, and it will give you a lot more options, man. Imagine, right? So sometimes you hold the button before and then someone actually closes out when you didn't expect it. You cannot change. You might have to use that bailout badge, but this will actually help you out if you wait. Now, if someone closed out, you do a simple dribble by pull up, simple money cash, and of course you don't have to deal with being penalized for holding down the button. Now, number five on my list is try to set your feet for higher percentage shots. Now, of course, I play with a bunch of shooters. Y'all know I'm a playmaker at heart. And one of their biggest complaints is, oh, why the game kid, like, it got me moving for this jump shot. But y'all gotta be it's very important for you to learn the animations, number one. Number two, there is a simple way that a kind of workaround to getting your feet set is, of course, tap the right stick. Remember, tap the right stick towards the ball hand. Now, this will kind of initiate the size up, which actually stops you on a dime, especially if you're dribbling the ball. Tapping the right stick to the ball hand actually stops you on a dime for you to get off the jump shot. This is a cheat I use all the time. But if you're doing it off a moving shot, it might benefit you to take like a split second to make sure that your feet is set so you could get this jump shot off and get a higher percentage off this jump shot. Number six on the list is learn the spacing needed to get your jump shot off, man. And I say your jump shot because it varies based on your jump shot release timing as well, your release speed, the defender's height, the defender's defensive ability is based off of a number of factors, but it's really important. The most elite shooters know the spacing needed to get their jump shot off. Now, this is something that will come over time with you constantly playing with your shooter, with you constantly playing with your jump shot, but it's something you definitely need to focus on and literally practice to really take you to that next level, man. So learn your jump shot spacing needed to get your jump shot on. Definitely make number six on my list. Now, number seven on my list is get the right badge combination to match your build. That's very important. Depending on your playing style, depending on your archetype or your build, the right badge combination could take your build to the next level. Me as my slashing playmaker. Now, the slashing playmaker, don't get tied up with the name. I still got an 80 on my 3 once I'm a 99. Now, the badges I really use, I only got 11 badge slots, but I still shoot like a sharpshooter, right? I got the difficult shot on gold, of course, flexible release, because you might be off when you don't have that bar on a little bit. You know, sometimes your timing might be off. The quick draw on gold and the range extender, those are the four badges I run with. Now, if you're a stretch, you might want to mix it up a little bit. Of course, you still need that quick draw, that range extender. You don't need difficult shot as much if you're a stretch, of course, but the green machine, that off ball, the slippery off ball, of course, as well, the catch and shoot is a really good badge, and just a bunch of good badge for y'all to mix and match and really figure out what combination works best for your build. So I suggest getting this down pack. If y'all want, personally, y'all could hit me up. I will help y'all out with the right badge combination. Of course, hit me up on Twitter. Y'all could hit me up in the comment section, and I will respond. Usually, man, y'all know how it goes, man. I'm always here to help y'all out, man. So remember, get the right badge combination to match your builds. Now, number eight on my list, man, and I ain't gonna front, man, how many times I hear the sharpshooter saying, I tried to pump fake, but they let me shot it. Yo, this is a tip for y'all, man, and it's just as effective as a pump fake. Is stop or avoid pump faking the ball and start using the pass fake. If y'all don't know how to pass fake, all right, now I ain't got the control in my hand, but I think it's you gotta tap the Y and B on the Xbox. And if you're on the PS4, you gotta tap triangle and the circle button to do the pass fix. Now this is less risky than the pump fix, but it's just as effective in terms of misleading defenders, in terms of sending defenders the wrong direction and getting you that needed space to get that jump shot off, man. As I said, I know how this sometimes, because sometimes it happened to me on a rare occasion that I actually decide to pump fake. But I'm telling y'all, for the most of the part, I play with a lot of shooters, and among the times they let that ball fly by accident, man, if I had a dollar, I would be rich. But anyways, man, yes, avoid using pump fake and add the pass fake to your repertoire. I promise you're gonna see a huge improvement in terms of getting that spacing needed to get that jump shot off. Now, number nine and final point that will help y'all take y'all to the next level in terms of shooting in NBA 2K20 is get yourself a monitor, man. Get yourself a monitor. Stop playing on TVs. Now, monitors are extremely cheap compared to TVs, man. I ain't going front. I got me two of them. I got me a 5 millisecond response time, and I got me a 1 millisecond response time monitor. The one I prefer to play on 2K, a lot of people say the one, but I prefer, it feels better for me when I'm playing on the 5 second response time, man. Right? So it don't necessarily have to be the quickest, like the one. Of course, I have that as well. All right, but it don't have to necessarily be the quickest at the 1 millisecond response time, but 5 milliseconds is way better than what TVs are offering, even if they're on game mode. But if you don't have a choice and have to stay on TV, please put it in game mode where you could get the quickest response time that could help your jump shot, man, because there's already enough latency that we got to compensate for in 2K without you having to experience it from your TV as well, man, to add more injury to itself, man. All right, so that's all I got for y'all, man. That's my 9 tips to help y'all make y'all more advanced and get y'all in the next level in the upper echelon of shooting, man. Y'all know how it is, man. I'm gonna start dropping tips and tricks like these from now on. Let me know how much this video helped y'all out by hitting that like and leaving it in the comment section, man. Y'all know how it is. This has been requested by multiple people, so I'm gonna get on it right now. Y'all know how it is. The grind is really now about to start for y'all, man. So don't forget, if you're first time to this channel, to make sure and like the video, share the video, hit your boy your subscribe for more daily tip and tricks video, man. All right, now if it's not your first time, like the video, share the video. You never know who is gonna help. Your boy Simon, love, respect, bless up, peace.